Amen. Well, welcome to Set Free Saturday Night Live. Want to welcome those on there, Miss Jane. So good news, maybe. Just talked to Janie, and she is, I'm not going to give you all the information and all that stuff, but hopefully next Saturday she's going to be here. So I'm going to get her broke out of the rainbow down there. Frank's with us, first time in a year, finally got him back. So the Lewises are on lockdown. We'll see those guys in a week or two and the Russells. So we just need to keep praying that this virus just goes and takes a hike. You know what I'm saying? Just come against that in Jesus' name and get rid of that garbage. So anyway, visitors, first time here. We got anybody first time here? No, those guys, most all of them been here before. Got to give me your name again. Joe, Christy, Granny Bev, Haley, and Amanda. That's our Conrad crew there. And they're throwing you under the bus over here, so. So you are? Ricky. And?
Drew.
And everybody else has been here?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. All right. Good deal. Good deal. Oh, somebody else is getting thrown under the bus here. Who am I missing? Oh, right here. So, Brian, Carol, Robin, and Jeff. Good to have you guys with us. Right on. Oh, and she tried to sneak in, but that was good. Good to see you here. And we got Mr. Jesse from Salvation Army, so good to have him with us. I told the boys I think he's coming to church because he feels guilty for dumping all that food on us every week. So, right on. And then we got Nick. Those of you who don't know, Nick was here. When were you here? 2013-14, went through the program, back in Ohio. Now just pray that he comes back. Amen. And so the last thing I got, Kim actually asked me last week how Pastor Naeem is. I actually talked to him, was it Sunday, last Sunday? He was 42 days in the hospital. He's been home, it was 2 weeks then, so he's been home for 3 weeks now, and he's still on oxygen. He's hoping to be preaching next Sunday, but he said Jesus stood, I get goosebumps on this, because the doctor told him and Elvira that if he makes it through the night, he's got a chance. So they thought he was going to die, and he said Jesus stood by his bed and said, "Do not fear," and he woke up the next morning and things been rocking and rolling. So Jesus can do whatever he wants to do. Oh, he said, "Do not fear, I am with you." So, yeah, he was all jacked up on the phone about what was going on, and it was good stuff. So, amen? All right, cowboy, you are on, sir.
All right, let's do our Set Free pledge. I am part of the fellowship of the unashamed. I have Holy Spirit power. The die has been cast. I've stepped over the line. The decision has been made. I'm a disciple of Jesus. I won't look back or let up, slow down, back away, or be still. My past is redeemed. My present makes sense. My future is secure. I'm finished and done with low-living, sight-walking, cheap-giving, and dwarf goals. I no longer need preeminence, prosperity, position, promotion, or popularity. I don't have to be right, recognized, praised, regarded, or recorded. I live by faith, walk by patience. My face is set, my gate is fast, my goal is heaven, my road is narrow, my way is rough, my companions are few. My guide is reliable, my mission is clear. I cannot be bought, compromised, deterred, hired away, turned back, deluded, or delayed. I will not flinch in the face of sacrifice or hesitate in the presence of the enemy. I will not give up, shut up, let up, stand up, prayed up. I will give till I drop, preach to all I know, and work till he stops me. And when he comes, my banner will be clear. Amen? If you bow your heads with me, we're going to bring in tonight's offering. Father God, Lord, we are just truly blessed. We thank you for all the things you're doing in our lives. Father God, just open our eyes, open our hearts. May we be in tune to you. Just looking for you to work and move in our lives. We thank you for that. We thank you for the chance to give. We thank you for the overwhelming chance to serve in your name. Father God, we just truly just thank you. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen.
Amen. Everybody stand to your feet. Everyone needs compassion, love that's never failing. Let mercy fall on me. Everyone needs forgiveness, the kindness of a Savior, the hope of nations. Amen. He's mighty to save. He can move the mountains. Amen. How many need mountains moved in your life? Amen. He is the author of salvation. He's the deliverer. He's the healer. Tanya is at Freedom Weekend this weekend in Fairfield. You know, if you need freedom, you don't have to go other places. God can set you free right here, right where you're at. Just bow down before him. Confess your faults to him. Everything that you have need of, he is the one who provides. He's Jehovah Jireh, our provider. If you need freedom, it's there. I like the little song. It says, just ask what the Lord can do. Just ask him. Whatever you have, call him up and tell him what you want. Amen? A little gospel. I might get off track here. So, but, you know, let's go. Who breaks the power? Oops. Change keys, because that'd be all. Who breaks the power of sin and darkness? Whose love is mighty and so much stronger? The King of glory, the King above all kings. Who shakes the whole world with holy thunder? Who leaves us breathless in awe and wonder? The King of glory, the King above all kings. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. Now you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You would lay down your life. That I would be set free. Oh, 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 Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. You would bear my cross.
sing for all that you've done for me. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me.
That he is the King of glory. He is worthy of our praise. He is worthy of everything. That he gave his life that we can have life and more abundantly. Amen. Amen. So sometimes you have to stop and not just sing the song, but think about what you're singing. He's the Messiah. He's the King of kings. That everything he's done, he's given us freely. It's a free gift. Amen. Want to have church tonight? So let the Spirit of the Lord just move. You know, these songs just declare what he has done, that he became sin that we might have life, that he took our place. No matter what we're going through, he has taken our place. We don't have to live in the past. The past is behind us. We're forgiven and we're set free. Amen. And he became sin, who knew no sin, that we might become his righteousness. He humbled himself, he carried the cross. Love so amazing, love so amazing.
In you. above all names. Blessed Redeemer, Emmanuel, the rescue for sinners, the ransom from heaven, Jesus Messiah.
Let's give him a praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, you are the King of kings and the Lord of lords. That, Lord, all our hope is in you. All our trust is in you, Father God. You are Jesus, Messiah, the King of kings and Lord of lords. Lord, you are all that we have need of. Lord, you go before us, Father God. You are behind us, Lord. You knew us from our mother's womb, Father God. Before the foundations of the earth were even formed, Father God, you knew us and had a plan for us, Father God. For it is already written down, the plans that you have for us, Lord, to prosper us, Lord, to make us holy, Father God. We thank you that, Lord, we were created in your image, Father God, to glorify you, Father. We thank you, Lord, that you are all that we have need of, Father. As we open up your word tonight, Father, Lord, let it penetrate our hearts, Father God. Lord, as we put on the whole armor of God, Lord, as we are clothed in your righteousness, Father God, Lord, all the sin is washed away and we are made whiter than snow, Father God. Lord, all our burdens are laid at the foot of the cross, that at the blood of Jesus and at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord of lords, Father God. We thank you, Lord, that one day we will see you face to face, Father God. Lord, in everything that we are concerned of here on earth, Father God, will fade in light of your presence, Father God, for your light will shine, Father God, upon us. And Lord, you will heal us and restore us, that we will have new bodies, Father God. We are a new creation in Christ. Lord, you live in us and dwell in us, Father God, that we are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Come on. Come on, come on, come on. God is so good. And I just thought of something as we're singing and praying there, that the visitors, when I'm talking about Pastor Naeem, you have no clue who I'm talking about. We support a church in Bethlehem. And what's the name of that book again? Yeah, the Stephen Curry book, his son's book. Ah, I should have been more prepared. But anyway, it's when we go to Israel, we go over to his church and hang out and do all sorts of different things. And they feed a whole bunch of people. They work in amongst the Muslim community and a lot of the Palestinians over there. And they're in the West Bank, of course. So it's a little hairier over there than in, I guess, what you call normal Israel. I think it's hairy all over the place over there. But it is good stuff to hear his voice and to hear him so excited about what God's doing. So, Bride, you got that picture for me? So there's a picture of the guy in the picture is Steve Saint. He's the son of Nate Saint, who was one of the five missionaries that was killed 65 years ago on January 8th while trying to share the gospel with the violent, and I can't ever say the tribe's name, Waranari tribe in the Ecuadorian rainforest. And that dude that's standing next to him right there is the guy that actually killed his dad, and now he is saved. So what really works to motivate Christ followers is to actually follow him. It's persecution. Persecution's coming, and pretenders all go away when the persecution starts. I think the church in North America is going to become more active and more committed to following Christ's commands. So, I always say we're not your mama's church, and I'm not here to pat you on your back, and, well, sometimes I am. But I'm here more to kick you in the rear, get you into your word, get you looking towards Jesus, get you to think about what's going on around you. I'm here to challenge you. I am here to encourage you. I want to get you lit up and on fire for Jesus, because that's what I want to do. And if we do that, things will change around you. But the big thing is, and there's a movie actually out called The End of the Spear about his dad and that tribe and all that stuff. That's good, Bri. Thank you, sir. If you ever get a chance to watch that movie, it's an amazing thing. So we're still talking about the armor. We're going to be on truth for a while, I think. Sorry about that, but no, I'm not. So I got a question for you. Do you really believe that what you believe is really real? Think about the question again. Do you really believe that what you believe is really real? So how many of you have ever heard of evangelical Christians? Well, you're going to learn something tonight then. We is kind of one of them. That is us's, okay? At least Set Free believes, and I'm going to read you, this is what we believe, so to see if you believe the way we believe. Or I'll just put, let me put me under the bus, the way I believe. How's that? Okay? So the word evangelical means, it's a Greek word, it means gospel or good news, okay? So the first thing, there's four things mainly under this heading, and tell you honest God truth, the evangelical crew is twisting sideways a little bit now too, so they got to hold on to this and quit twisting. But anyway, the original part is the Bible is the highest authority for what I believe. This is it. This is the number one authority. Yeah, there's other stuff that goes on, but if it doesn't line up with this, something's haywire. Second thing is, it's very important for me personally to encourage non-Christians to trust Jesus Christ as their Savior. That is, Jesus is God, the Son of God. So I'm always pushing you, always encouraging you to get out and do what? Share your testimony. Get out and share what Jesus Christ has done in your life so other people can... Whew. We talk about it in devotions. There's three firemen that are kind of hanging around that I used to hang around with. One of them didn't know me in the old days, but the other two did. And they've been telling stories to the boys. There's your testimony. In fact, what did one of them tell you? When you're doing the roof?
One day he just showed up at the fire station and he wasn't JP anymore. He was home never.
And that wasn't because of me, that was because of Jesus. Easy. There was a big shakeup in our family when that happened. Third thing, Christ's death on the cross is the only sacrifice that could remove the penalty of my sin. That's the good news right there. And the fourth thing is, only those who trust in Jesus Christ alone as their Savior receive God's free gift of eternal salvation. There's your basic down-to-earth, this is what me believe in. And if you're in there, then God's got some stuff for you to do. John 14:6, flip over there. We were hitting on this a little bit last week. We're going to be jumping in all over the place today. John 14:6, Jesus said to him, I am the only way to God and the real truth and the real life. No one comes to the Father but through Jesus. What's the opposite of truth? We all agree with that? The opposite of truth is a lie, right? And lying goes against the very nature and character of God. He can't lie. His nature is not to lie. He is 100% truth. And what is Jesus? He is the truth. What is the Holy Ghost? He's the Spirit of truth. There's nothing but truth. How do we get deceived? by lies. Look at Colossians 2:8. Turn to your right here just a little bit. Here's a warning to us. It says, see to it that no one takes you captive through philosophy and empty deception, pseudo-intelligent babble, according to the tradition and musings of mere men, following the elementary principles of this world, rather than following the truth, the teachings of Christ. Now go up to verse 6. Here's where we should be at. Therefore, as you have received Christ Jesus the Lord, walk in union with him, reflecting his character in the things you do and say, living lives that lead others away from sin. Having been deeply rooted in him and now being continually built up in him and becoming increasingly more established in your faith just as you were taught and overflowing in it with gratitude. Don't be deceived. If you're politically correct, you gotta watch what I say here. Don't give me that eyebrow. Let me just put it this way. I'm not politically correct, okay? And I have a hard time. There's sometimes that you go into places that you know they don't believe the way you believe, and you try to be politically correct, but not. Does that make any sense? Because you don't want to go in there and just drop a big old bomb on somebody and then have them all ticked off at you for the rest of the day. You kind of want to just ease into ticking them off. At least that's what I try to do. We've got to always come back to this. Always come back to this. Go to 2 Thessalonians. Keep going right here. Second Thessalonians chapter 2, starting in verse 9, says this. The coming of the Antichrist, the lawless one, is through the activity of Satan, attended with great power, all kinds of counterfeit miracles and deceptive signs and false wonders, all of them lies, and by unlimited seduction to evil and with all the deception of wickedness for those who are perishing because they did not welcome the love of the truth of the gospel so as to be saved. They were spiritually blind and rejected the truth that would have saved them. Because of this, God will send upon them a misleading influence. Now, did you hear that? Listen to verse 11. Because of this, who's going to send it? God is. God will send upon them a misleading influence, an activity of error and deception, so they will believe the lie in order that all may be judged and condemned who did not believe the truth about their sin and the need for salvation through Christ, but instead took pleasure in unrighteousness. But we should and are morally obligated as debtors always to give thanks to God for you, believers, beloved by the Lord, because God has chosen you from the beginning for salvation through the sanctifying work of the Spirit that sets you apart for God's purpose and by your faith in the truth of God's word that leads you to spiritual maturity. It says God's going to send upon them a misleading influence. Why? Because they're spiritually blind and they don't want to hear the truth. Can you remember before you got saved, and I don't know how many people are in here that are saved, and we're praying that if you're not, the Holy Spirit's going to touch your heart tonight and things are going to change. But can you remember back before you were saved, and people would talk to you about Jesus, how closed off you were? If Leo Hertz was here, he could tell you, Leo used to preach to me all the time. I literally had Leo up against the wall in the fire station one time and told him to quit talking about Jesus. You're full of piss and vinegar tonight. was raised in the church from little kid. Knew all about Jesus where? In my head. Didn't have nothing here. So all he was doing was aggravating me all the time. But in the process of that aggravation, he kept planting what? Seeds in my heart. So if somebody gets mad at you for sharing the gospel, don't quit. Come on, don't quit. They start swearing, cussing at you, throwing stuff at you, jacking you up against the wall. Leo didn't quit. He was a little bit more careful. But he did not quit sharing the gospel of Jesus Christ with me. I already asked you this question. What takes you and me captive? A lie. Turn to 2 Timothy. You're right here. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 3 and 4 says this. For the time will come when people will not tolerate sound doctrine and accurate instruction that challenges them with God's truth. But wanting to have their ears tickled with something pleasing, they will accumulate for themselves many teachers, one after another, chosen to satisfy their own desires and to support the errors they hold, and will turn their ears away from the truth and wander off into myths and man-made fictions and will accept the unacceptable. I got to give you guys credit for keep coming back on Saturday night, because I know I step on your toes a lot. But again, I don't think I know God hasn't called me to go, oh, everything's just going to be all right. Just, you're all good. You can just keep right on sinning and doing whatever you want. God didn't call me to do that. God called me to challenge you. God called me to drive you into this. And it's the deception that draws us away from Jesus Christ. God's word, the Holy Spirit, is the spirit of truth. And everybody calls it a conscience, but you know that conscience really is the Holy Spirit within you. Think about this, because when you screw up, when you say something, when you do something wrong, what happens? You get that conviction shot. Well, that's the Holy Ghost working in your life, trying to get you back onto the right track. And if you keep pushing that away, what's going to happen? That 2x4 gets a little bit slimmer. Pretty soon it's just a twig hitting you in the back of the head, and you'll just blow it off and just keep right on doing what you want to do. And you believed the deception and fell for the lie, and you took off and went your own way. We all know people that have done that. Now I'm going to get myself in trouble, but that's all right. Here we go. What are some of the lies that the politically correctness is trying to spread it to the whole world? And it's actually in the church now too. But one of the lies is all religions are the same. You seen that bumper sticker? And it's got all the different, I can't remember what it says. What does it say? Coexist, that's it. And it's got every one of them on there. They don't coexist. There's only one God, true God. His name is Jesus, God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. And all those other things are just man-made stuff. People aren't losing their lives over Buddha and Krishna. They're not losing their heads because they're worshiping Buddha. They're not losing their heads because they're worshiping Krishna. They're not losing their heads because they're worshiping some idol. They're losing their heads because they're worshiping Jesus Christ. Hello? Another one of the lies, the Bible isn't relative for today. That has been written a long time ago. It's not relative for today. The Bible says Jesus was the same yesterday, today, and forever. Why is the Bible still banned in certain countries? Because it's too much in your face. And people, that persecution thing they are saying, you know what, the underground church in China, in Iran, in Afghanistan, in all these countries that are Muslim ruled, guess what? The underground church is blowing up. And when you give your life to Jesus over there, it's not one you go skipping down the street going, I just gave my life to Jesus. Because you're probably going to lose your head that fast. But it's the underground and the Holy Spirit's working in amongst everybody, and the truth is revealed, and people get set free. This one I'm going to make some of you mad. It makes me mad just reading it. There are 64 genders. I just looked it up on Google before I come. 64 genders out there right now in a U.S. of A. God created us boys and boys. Boys are boys. Girls are girls. And that's how God created us. Now, I know people that are say they're this, trans, they're this, they're the cis, Joe, whatever. I know people like that, you know what? And I'm still going to befriend them. Hello? Why is that? Because they need the love of Jesus to get set free. And you don't want to bash them in the head, you're going to hell. That isn't going to help them get a relationship with Jesus Christ. You still got to pour out the love of Jesus Christ to them, but you need to take a stand and say, but this is what the Bible says. And it's clear, as crystal clear on the other night when the moon was. Did you see that moon the other night? Oh, my gosh. Anyway, get me all messed up here, Kim, going the other direction. Here's another one. Everyone's going to heaven. If you're good and you just do good things, everybody's going to heaven. And there is no hell. We're living in hell right now. That's one of the biggest lies that people tell, is that this is hell and there is no such thing as when you die, you die. I was listening to some guy on that, I'm listening to a thing called the Truth Project. And he says, when you die, you just go back to the dirt. And I'm thinking, well, if you go back to the dirt, where'd you come from in the first place? Come on. Here's one that gets people all fired up, too. A baby isn't a baby until it's born or it has a heartbeat. I hear that all the time. Because I get people want me to go protest at the Planned Parenthood. I won't go protest. And you'll say, well, why not? Because if there's a lady that goes in there and she does have an abortion, you know God can forgive that. If you've had an abortion in here, please know God will forgive you, okay? But I'm not going to be standing out there with a sign and she goes in and she does have the abortion and comes out and sees me standing with the sign. Now, those of you that are called to do that, go do that. I'm all for you. But I don't want her to come walking in that back door and see me standing up here, and all she remembers is me standing there with that sign. Hello? So we're all got different callings. But I want to be able to touch her, not condemn her. Hello? And there's all sorts of scriptures, Jeremiah 1, Isaiah 44, Galatians 1 talks about that God knows us even before we're in the, did you hear that? God knows us even before we're in the, another one is don't worry about Israel. Just leave the Jews alone. They're all screwed up. This is that, and it's that. You know, I read in here that it says the Jews are his, and it hasn't changed yet. I didn't see a correction. I know that we're adopted. I don't know, you're going to hear this a little. We're adopted in. So I always tell everybody, I'm an adopted Jew. What? That's right. I'm an adopted Jew. I'm a Norwegian Jew. No? It works for me. We're adopted into the vine. I mean, come on. There's so many, we've been reading in the devotions, there's so many things where it says that they came for the Gentiles. Every time it says they came for the Gentiles, we should be shouting. Because he came for us too. Amen? Look at 2 Corinthians. Oh, no. Are you serious? Well, we're going to get a couple in. Where's my boy? Why don't you guys go get ready to get baptized here? And what did I say, 2 Corinthians? I'll get there. Amplified. 2 Corinthians 11. Starting in verse 14 says this. It says, no wonder, since Satan himself masquerades as an angel of light. So it is no great surprise if his servants also masquerade as servants of righteousness, but their end will correspond with their deeds. The devil's great at, he'll put a little bit of truth in there to make it sound really good, and then all the rest is trash, but we hear that one part and then we just jump into it, and we don't go back and check. We need to be in here and check. I don't care if you hear me preach, hear anybody preach, you better go back in here and make sure what we're saying is in here. Because you heard about that other scripture I read, said there's going to be many false teachers, many false people coming up, and they're going to be teaching you false things. And if you just sit there like sheeple and don't check it, anybody can lead you astray. There's a whole bunch of preachers. That are saying things that don't line up with this. Let me just put it the easy way here. There's a lot of great preachers out there. There's a lot of great ministers out there. There's a lot of great Bibles. I mean, you can get on YouTube and watch Bible studies all day long, watch preachers all day long, and there's some awesome stuff on there. But don't listen to all of it and just take it in as gospel without checking it for your own self. When you get to heaven and stand before Jesus, I'm not going to be standing there with you. Well, JT said this. Hello? You're going to be standing there in your birthday suit all by your lonesome. And you ain't going to be standing in your birthday suit anyway. You're going to be in the old, new, everything's going to be awesome. Back to the Adam and Eve stuff. You know what I mean? Cruising through the garden. There was the biggest lie right there. All started, going to be like God. Did God really say? What was he doing with Eve? He was putting doubt and maybe some unbelief in there. And then stupid Adam, everybody always blames Eve. And yeah, she's the one that started it. But it says her husband was standing there with her. He got it right at the start. And us boys just, oh, yeah, whatever. Whatever you say, girlfriend. And all of us went from the lie. I got time for one more. John 8. John chapter 8. There they are. We'll read this one and get on with it here. John 8, 42 through 47 says this. Jesus said to them, "If God were your Father, but he is not, you would love and recognize me, for I came from God out of his very presence and have arrived here. For I have not even come on my own initiative as self-appointed, but he is the one who sent me. Why do you misunderstand what I'm saying? It is because your spiritual ears are deaf and you are unable to hear the truth of my word. You are of your father, the devil, and it is your will to practice the desires which are characteristic of your father. He was a murderer from the beginning and does not stand in the truth because there is no truth in him. When he lies, he speaks what is natural to him, for he is a liar and the father of lies and half-truths. But," I love the big buts in here, "but because I speak the truth, you do not believe me and continue in your own unbelief. Which of you has proof and convicts me of sin? If I speak truth, why do you not believe me? Whoever is of God and belongs to him hears the truth of God's words. For this reason, you do not hear them because you are not of God and you are not in fellowship with him." Cool thing is, if you're hearing the word, what is that saying to you? You're in. Hello? You ought to be going, "Yeah, I'm in. I'm hearing the word. Things are good. I'm getting pumped up. I'm getting," you know, the good thing about it is when conviction comes, you know you're really in with God. People don't like conviction, but you know what? If you're not getting convicted, you might want to check what you're doing. Hello? I got too much more to go here. So we need to suit up with Jesus Christ. That belt of truth, we're going to talk about truth next week too, because I think it all bases off that one thing. Jesus Christ is truth, the Word is truth, the Spirit of God is truth. Everything revolves around Jesus, and it's all right here. And if we don't put on the belt of truth, everything else is just going to go haywire. Amen? All right, Bri, hit the video for us. Here, Mr. Greg's on it.
Hi, my name is Greg Philip McMurtry. I'm 40 years old, born June 29, 1980, on a naval base in Lemoore, California. Part of my life, I was raised in Southern California around a family of violence, abuse, drugs, of a broken family. I was placed in institutions at a young age. Shortly when we moved to Colorado, my family broke up with torment and hurt. I eventually found myself moving around institutions of all kinds and states. I eventually found myself broken. Drugs became my life and consumed me. I eventually found myself where God was reaching to me, but kept running from him, not surrendering to him, and not giving him my all. So I experienced my own pain of trials, tribulations, hurt of others, including myself, but most of all, I disappointed and hurt God. I did, however, back in 98, got baptized through the Lord Jesus Christ, but shortly after that, I slipped away to worldly things. I eventually found myself years later in Christian men's homes where I was told by disciples if I left it would get worse than it did. While I was in my ways, I was sitting at Boulder Creek in Colorado, saw Jesus walking, so he reaches out to me again. God, Lord Jesus Christ, is working through me in my life right now and shaping to turn me away from sinful nature of all kinds, to turn to him instead of worldly ways, to keep the devil at bay during temptations and of him, and allowing Lord Jesus Christ to heal me from being hard on myself and hurtful things in my life, and to guide me in his will of guidance, especially people who lie against me. Thanks to my Christian brothers and sisters, I rededicate my life and renounce my past life and acceptance and receiving the mercy and grace of forgiveness of the Lord God Jesus Christ over my life. As I have came to believe, he has given me many chances, and I would dislike to disappoint him further. So I pick up my cross and give Jesus rule over my body, spirit, and soul, heart, to reign over my whole life into one body with him, to knock the devil on his back. For I am set free. God bless the world and heal it.
Amen. Amen. Whoa, he's all ready to go. Pull him up for Hang on. You're going to get dunked twice here, Junior. So, great. Hang on. Are you excited about this?
Yeah.
I see that. That's good. Do you love Jesus?
Yes, I do.
All right. So, Greg, it is our privilege to baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Yeah. I love it. That's talking about getting excited about getting baptized, you know what I mean? Have you ever seen on the YouTube video, there's this little black kid is standing in the tub, and there's this preacher, he's going on and on, and the little kid's looking at him, he's going on and on. Finally, the little kid just goes, he's tired of waiting for him. He wants to get baptized. He's got to get out of here. That's our boy. Let's pray, and away we go. Father, in Jesus' name, I do just thank you for your belt of truth. Father, help us to walk. Help us to look to you and follow your trail, Father God, just as close as we can get, like the old rabbis with the dust coming off their feet. Let us get some Holy Ghost dust on us, following you wherever you go. Father, just continue to pump the truth into us. Help us to recognize deception. Help us to recognize the lies. And help us just to be bold enough to stand up against those things. Father, I just thank you. If there's somebody in here tonight, Father God, that does not know Jesus Christ as their personal Lord and Savior, Father, I just pray right now that the Holy Spirit would touch their hearts, convict their hearts of their sin, and that they just repent of all their sins and accept Jesus Christ as their personal Lord and Savior. Father God, you know how that goes. With one-on-one personal relationship with that, we want to give you all the praise, honor, and glory tonight and just thank you for what you're doing in amongst this crew. We give you the praise tonight in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. We love you. We'll see you later.